And welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Ball Z Kakarot Part 2. Yeah. Last time we defeated Piccolo in the opening, we collected apples and went fishing and did a campfire and we met up with Chi-Chi and we met up and also we went to the Kami house and met up with all our friends so that I could introduce who's Gohan to everyone. And also, we played as Piccolo by defeating Raditz and as Goku. We defeated Raditz, and but Gohan has been kidnapped by Raditz. So Piccolo and I teamed up, and we also finished two submissions, with three submissions total, including Roshi's treasure, and let's see, Nam and Android 8. So now we're playing as Kid Gohan. And we have to search for food in the surrounding area. Because Piccolo left Gohan to train. We skip. Lag. Now we're gonna play as Piccolo. Piccolo's special beam cannon super attacks now available. Super attacks unlocked in the story. As you progress through the main story, you'll gain access to new super attacks, whether you've acquired them through the story from a training ground location. You'll need to set them to your super attack palette to use them. Go see how Gohan's doing. This is Gohan's guardian. Oh, look, a D medal. Okay. I'm gonna check how Gohan's doing. Oh. We're gonna be collecting, but first of all, I'm gonna collect some orbs. I'm gonna go for the items and stuff. Get some more orbs. Gizzard Wasteland. Fight some more robots. Hey, look, we got a new enemy called Skull Robot Type 2. Let's use Explosive Wave. Oh, come on. Charge up your key, man. Come on, come on, please. There we go. Oh man. That's a level 3. I'll have to fight those guys so I can level up. Come on, please don't hit me. Yes, there we go. Now I'm gonna be quiet. Right now. Metal. Now Goku is in other world after Piccolo used a special beam cannon on Raditz and Goku. I mean, the two Saiyans were remaining, including Nappa and Vegeta. Nappa's the bald guy, right? Can't believe Vegeta called Raditz a low-class warrior. It's just like Goku and Goku's father, Bardock. Oh yeah, Bardock is voiced by Sonny Strait as well. I gotta tell you, Phil Parsons did the voice of Nappa in this game. You know something? That Phil Parsons did the voice of Kenny Ackerman from Attack on Titans Season 3. In other words, he did Jabra from One Piece and Burgess. And let's see who else? Capitay. They're from what? These three guys are from One Piece that Phil Parsons did. Well, let's carry on. I'm gonna start beating the crap out of these annoying robots. Gonna give them a taste of his own medicine. Come on. Seriously? Well. That shows the moves, boss. I'll just keep be quiet and keep collecting more items and all that stuff. Piccolo is a Namekian right now. From planet Namek, right. And Kami's a Namekian too. Hey, look, the World Tournament announcer. Yeah, Eric Vale did the voice of the World Tournament announcer in Trunks, Future Trunks too. Ladies and gentlemen, let the 24th World Tournament begin. Oh, you kind of caught me by surprise there. I'm trying to get ready for the next World Tournament, but I'm thinking about changing things up a bit. But you know, if my intro isn't broken, I probably should have tried to fix it, huh? Hey, you should enter the next tournament. Here, you can have this. Should help you train. Power protein. Okay. Now shut up this time. Oh look, it's King Piccolo. The main villain from Dragon Ball. What was that? Lake Bog. I'm gonna pause for a moment. Characters. What? Super attack. Tree skill. Skill tree. A charging melee attack with high guard break damage. Demon flash strike. Level 2. Power, rapid fire key wave, maybe I can use some items. Okay, should probably try a whole roast on the bone. If that helps. Why does everything have to be only 1 HP? Seriously. I'm gonna have to go to the community right now. Let's use Nam. Nope. Can't use Roshi. Never mind. Let's stay focused from now on. Stay away from me. Yep. Level 6. Nice. Level up. That's cool. Come on. More D metal. Nice. I'm gonna get some more orbs. Let's be quiet. Oh wow. Stop. Herbs. Collect some of those. Yep. Some more beast meat. Yes. Yeah, that's all. Some wolves. great fortune teller Baba again. Wow. When you see a racing flag, all you're gonna have to do is get a vehicle. You need some vehicles. That's for sure. Silk apron. D metal. Oh, there. Sounds something. Earrings, earn. Where's the cook? Let's talk to the tour guide. Man, that's a lot of money. Alright. Desserts. Sugary cupcakes. You need 4 milk. You need 4 milk. Four milks. Yeah, you don't want to give Edward Elric milk. It'll freak him out. Kill these guys. Alright. More wolves. Yeah, these herbs, don't they kind of remind you of Resident Evil? It's one of the healing items that you can use. As long as you combine the green herb with the red herb, it'll help you restore full health. Alright, the blue ones, they cure poison. You can't use a red herb by itself, because it's useless. You can we combine them with green. There we go. Got some robots to battle. Three of them to kill all the enemies in the area. Yeah, there's gonna be some skull robots patrolling the area. They're gonna attack Gohan. Got fossil everywhere. Let's see if I can check this one more time. Well, this is BP, is your experience points. You gotta have 1,562 points. That's for sure. Just checking my status, guys. That's not enough. Grab, get some more eggs. And shut up. Burning tofu. Alright. Tofu cooked in spices that would set your whole body on fire. It's hot, but it'll leave you wanting more. He's gonna give you acid reflux, that's for sure. Cured cupcake. Alright, a light and fluffy cupcake loaded with sugar. The Perfect dessert for anyone with a sweet tooth. I'll have to hold on to those just in case. We race cars here. If you want to race, then get yourself a car first. Oh, you need a car. Definitely need a car. All right. Yay. What's on top of that tree stump? Oh, what's in there? Eggs and a D metal. There's a fishing area over there that I could use. Some fish eggs and energetic fish. Whenever you see something red, glowing red, that's definitely rare items. They're level 5. And Both are level 3. Gotcha. Attack. Okay, go back for the source. Some lean dino meat. Now I gotta use some items. Sugary cupcake. Let's use that. They boost your status, including your health. Plus 75. Let's beat these skull robo punks up. After the other one, the last three robots. Then. I'll take care of him. Oh, gotta get that last orb. Green one. Those are the ones for the mission, right? Let's just beat the crud out of these annoying robots. Come on, die. Finish. 146. Gotta see how Gohan's doing again. The rainbow orb. Come on. Let's collect this one. And let's see. More of these. Whoops, wrong button. Please don't fly. Yeah, let's go. Whoop, stop that. Come on. There's a D-metal over there. It is easier if I can sense objects. Let's see here. Come on, there he is. Pick up that D-metal. Alright, I'm ready. Time to observe some pterosaurs. Okay. Okay, get these orbs. Wolves. That big one up. See Gohan sleeping. He's so hungry. Collect some apples for Gohan. Looks like I already got some. As Goku traverses Snake Way in the other world, with hope of getting stronger, Piccolo attempts to toughen Gohan up and awaken his latent power by leaving him to fend for himself in the wilderness. Oh, it's nighttime, so we gotta battle Gohan. It's gonna be a real pain in the butt. He's gonna use a mouth cannon on you. Let's see if I could. Gotta watch out for his powerful punch. Gohan turned into a big ape because he looked up at the full moon. Watch out! Watch out for that earthquake attack. Charge up your key, bro. Don't go near his face. Mouth cannon. Oh my god. It's a lot powerful than ever. What are you doing? Oh, come on. Kick his butt. Gotcha. Huzzah. Leveled up. Now Piccolo tore off the tail, and he gave Gohan one of Goku's uniforms. The GI uniform, that's for sure. Skip that. It was on episode 8 of Dragon Ball Z, Gohan Goes Bananas. Any Saiyan that looks up at the full moon turns into big apes. Any Saiyans that do it. I mean, why do Saiyans turn into big apes? That makes no sense. It's like a werewolf transformation. There were big apes in the Dragon Ball Z movie episode of Bardock. And also, the one when Gohan turned into a big ape when fighting Turles, Piccolo leaves Gohan on his own and several months pass. It smells good, dude. You can't fly while you're moving. Ooh, okay, we already gave the apples to Gohan. Search your surroundings for anything suspicious. No, you can't fly. But you can also jump and run. Oh, meat dumplings? What are you, Luffy from One Piece? Luffy does love meat. Fish, bro. No, Gohan has a sword. Why does he have a big sword there on his back? Oh, that is one big fish. That's a Goliath catfish. You, yay. Okay. Hey, it's Yajirobe. He's the Corrin Tower Fender. He works for Corrin the cat. While moving on the field, use LB to search your surroundings for key and detect where you can find materials and other items. The location of the item will glow when detected. If you're having trouble finding something to progress the story, just search the area for key. catch three deer. Alright. We gotta give three deers to Yajirobe. Yeah, that's right. Come on, bro. Alright. They're the ones. Come on. I gotta use a key blast so I can knock them out. Come on. Get back here. One down. Oh, look, a mountain deer. One down. Two more left. Alright. What do we have here? A D metal. Collecting so many D metals. And get the orbs. Yeah. Caught them all. Tell Yajirobe how the hunt went. Go ahead. I'm gonna hunt for some more deers. Come on. Keep going, Gohan. Yep. There we go. Come on. Got the soul emblem. Got an adventurer community leader, Yajirobe, and unlocked a new community board. Alright. In this community, you can activate community skills that will help you on your adventure. Focus on this community if you want more HP and ki on your adventure. Oh. It's gotta be about items. Okay. Several more months passed since Gohan ran into Yajirobe. Piccolo, training on his own, notices something strange. Uh-oh. The Saiyans got 1,686 experience. Find the source of the power that you sensed. Probably power up. Come on. Ouch. Come on, die. Get away from me. Okay, don't get too close when he's using a tail whip. Oh. I gotta find these guys that I sensed. Right. There. Die. Wanting metal. I'll keep collecting them. Alright then. Come on. There's another one over there. And then another Deem Metal. But I can sense that they're level 3. Oh, there's Yamcha over there. Yeah, I remember him from Dragon Ball Episode 4, the Desert Bandit. But now he's a Z Fighter. Yamcha is voiced by Christopher Sabat as well. He's at a level 4. Come on. Come on, stop that. Stop. You're hitting me with a spirit ball. That's one of his moves. Come on, Yamcha. Seriously, stop that. Come on. Charge up. Waiting for it. Ouch. Why is he hitting me with that stupid spirit ball? Man, he's strong. Come on. Do you get an S rank? Yes. That's good. Now I'm leveled up. We got Soul Emblem from Yamcha. A Yamcha Soul Emblem, that is. Okay. But first of all, I'm gonna use my characters right now. So, Super Attack Palette. Cool. Special Beam Cannon. That's the move. The same move he used on Raditz. But next, let's see here. You gotta reach a level 10. To unlock these, you have to reach a higher level. And then you gotta do all these trainings. Now let's focus, shall we? Come on. Oh! I miss D metal. Let's battle Krillin. He's at a level 5. Ouch. Special beam. Oh, come on. Really? Gotta avoid the Kamehameha attack. Okay, come on. That's not critical enough. Come on, special beam cannon. He just provoked him by calling him a weakling? Seriously, stop hitting me with your Kamehameha waves, Krillin. Come on, don't dodge. No! Let's see. I could try. God, his own for size, that is. Oh my God, he's... That red aura is probably a burst. Take that, Krillin. Six experience. Go back to your train, man. I'll just go over there. Wrong button. Tofu. Crispy skin fish grilled to perfection. Its succulent and aroma. Its succulent aroma is enticing to hungry people and cats alike. What kind of cats? Meaty rice ball. No. Peaches right now, so let's get out of here. Hey, look, turtle in Pilaf. Pilaf gang. Whew, how refreshing. I'm glad I'm able to find some water. No more mushroom picking for me. I thought I tried some bamboo shoot picking instead, but its spice seemed to have gotten lost. Oh well, I'm not really in a hurry to get back to sea. Oh, since you're there, you can have some of this. Now then, which way to the sea? Bamboo shoot, three of them. Shut up. Okay. Okay, let's talk to them. Hey, Shu, Mike, get in there! What? But there's a dinosaur! I can't do it. Who the heck are you? Get out of there. Rude? Why did he have to be so rude? Stop fooling around, Piccolo, and let's go. Still doing it. About Tien and Chiaotzu. Tien, you're a lot stronger. Oh, okay, let's talk to Tien. Why is Tien not wearing a shirt? He has a scar on his chest from Tao. Piccolo. Alright. Okay, we're gonna battle Tien and Chiaotzu. Alright, Tien is voiced by John Bergemeyer, who does the voice of Kurama from Yu Yu Hakusho. Come on, stop that. Maybe I'll try Rapid Fire Key Blast? Going for the combo moves. I think that's one of my favorite moves. Seriously, that hurt. Then he learns Tri-Beam. Wow, Tien fought Goku in the World Martial Arts Tournament ever since he was a kid. And Goku fought Chiaotzu as well. On the Tien Shinhan Saga. Yeah, take that. Yeah, we're not really gonna fight Chiaotzu, just Tien. Right. Okay, got Tien. Oh great. Oh, we got Soul Emblem for Piccolo and Tien. Alright. Now we got some submissions. Put Gohan straight into the test. Let's go help Yajirobe first. I didn't exactly eat like a king when I was training at Kami's place. My body's craving meat.
Hey, you there.
What? Piccolo? What the hell are you doing here?
I couldn't help but overhear you trained with Kami.
Well, maybe train ain't the right word. I'm just there to, you know, check things out.
I felt a strong key here, but him? Maybe he's been really training at Kami's place.
Which means this clown might challenge me to a fight, just like the others.
Yajirobe mentioned he trained with Kami, so he's gotta be looking for a fight. Take him down first.
I'm gonna say yes. The fifth trainee.
When does he plan on attacking?
Sheesh, get a load of that scary look. What's this guy's problem?
That expression of his, he's clearly calculating the best time to strike.
Well, so much for having a nice, relaxing meal. Why is he not making a move? What the hell is he thinking?
Wait, Piccolo's not trying to eat me, is he? I made this fire for my food, not to get roasted over. I guess I'm going to have to start this. What are you doing here?
One wrong move and I'm this guy's snack. I need to calm down and watch what I say. I was getting kind of hungry, so I thought I'd make something to eat. Oh crap, I should have mentioned that. Now he's going to have food on the mind. I'm lunch now.
So he's relaxed enough to just casually prepare a meal in front of me? He's messing with me.
I gotta get out of here. Oh, I know.
Well, I gotta finish preparing my meal, so I'll have to hunt something.
That'll be my chance to make a break for it. Damn, that's some quick thinking on my part.
He honestly thinks I'm going to let him pretend to go on a hunt and let my guard down?
I see. I'll go hunt you something. You stay here and finish your preparation.
Don't go anywhere, got it?
Why would I go anywhere? You think I'm gonna just leave when I'm this hungry? You hunting for me, saving me a ton of work. Come on. Hurry up and leave already.
Man, Yajirobe was so scared. Let's Piccolo catch six deer. Alright. Well, I'm gonna go deer hunting. If they were rabbits there, that would have been weird.
Shh. Be quiet.
I'm hunting deer. There it is. There they are. Wow, more deers. Alright, this ought to be enough. Now head back. Where the hell did he go? Wait. He's probably planning a sneak attack. What a fool. Alright, you can hide all you want, but I can sense your key and find out where you are. As Piccolo, search for Yajirobe's key and find him. Alright, let's find him. I remember Yajirobe killed Symbol, one of King Piccolo's henchmen. Symbol was just a weakling. So now Yajirobe had to cook Symbol and eat him up. I mean, why would he eat Symbol? Find him. Come on, where could he be? Oh wow. When you use your key around the pterodactyls, all you see is glowing dots over there. What do we have here? Stop. Come on, blast him. A blue pterosaur. There he is. Nope. Come on. Where are you, Yajirobe? Nope. Probably over there. Why? Ah, stay out of my way. Gotta be on that tree, right? If I could use my key to search for him. There he is. Oh, we got a D-metal. Perfect. Talk to him. There he is. Why is he hiding like a coward? There you are. Show yourself. You want me to blast those rocks and you into oblivion? I can't shake this guy. I'm dead meat for sure. I was just, you know, relieving myself. Relieving yourself? Fast search. No more excuses. If you're going to fight me, then come at me already. What? I wasn't gonna fight you. Are you insane? Wait, I mean, I'm not gonna fight you because I can't. Because of my intense training at commies, my blade ain't as sharp as it used to be. Then I'll get you a new one. Wait here. It ain't that simple. This ain't no ordinary sword. It was forged by the most badass blacksmith around. I was planning on having him take a look at it and seeing what he could do. So yeah, a fight ain't gonna happen. Sorry, without my sword, not much of a challenge. Fine, but let me say this. When you do fight me, do it fair and square. No more funny business, got it? Of course, trust me, I can't wait to fight you. I gotta get out of here and go somewhere real far away. And we got chicken, beast meat, bronze compass, D-metal, 376 EXP. There we go. Okay, next up, there's Chatsu. I really care about improving myself. Alright, talk to him. You'll see, I will become stronger. Oh. Do you have a second? Chatsu's is preparing for the coming battle with the Saiyans, but something's got him worried. I gotta tell you something. Chatsu is voiced by Brina Palencia, who does the voice of Tony Chopper from One Piece. Oh, I forgot to mention to you, Sunny Strait did the voice of Usopp from One Piece. Brina Palencia did the voice of let's see, Mineta from My Hero Academia. The annoying grape hero. Alright, let's just focus. Let's go battle, Chatsu. Telekinesis training. Yes, telekinetic powers like General Blue. What do you want? Spit it out.
Take this.
What the? Paralysis? Ugh. I don't know what you're trying to pull, but you're obviously willing to throw your life away.
Stop.
What?
What?
Sorry for not warning you earlier, but Chaz is just testing a technique to use on the Saiyans. We're going to need his power in the fight ahead. Don't be ridiculous. What good is a small fry like him?
Release him, Chaozu!
Give me a break. This technique's not enough to contain me. You're about to find out just how strong Chaozu really is.
But Tien, I...
Don't worry. I'm going to fight too. After all, you and I are a team. Each of us is powerful because we support each other. Let's show this creep what the two of us can do.
Okay.
Idiot. Oh, we're gonna fight Tien and Chaozu for the second time. I'm gonna fight Tien. Second time and his partner Chaozu. I'm gonna fight Chaozu. Alright. Tien's at a level 5 and Chaozu's at a level 4. But let's dodge that tri beam. Charge up your key. Keep using those blasts. I'm gonna keep using my combos. Where are you, Chaozu? Oh man, that's a heck of a lot of combos. Don't get hit. Ouch! Okay, you just got hit. Oh man. Whoa! Oh, charge up, bro. Seriously, stop hitting me. Enough. Why is he using a tri beam? Oh, Dodon Ray. Not just Tien, but Chaozu as well. Damn. No surprises there. That wasn't much of a fight. Weaklings like you are just going to be cannon fodder for the Saiyans.
I'm sorry, Tien. If I weren't so weak...
Don't give up, Chaozu. We still got a lot to do. We have to train hard enough to beat the Saiyans and show everyone we're not to be taken lightly.
What? If my technique doesn't work on the Saiyans, then I've got no other choice.
Oh, wow. You got 489...
489 EXP, 1 D Metal, 1 Bronze Compass, and 2 Mega Mass Level 1. Yeah, we got a Soul Emblem from Chaozu. Yep. Here we go. You can dash into enemies when you're 5 times higher level than them. Okay. Okay. Let's put Gohan's training to the test. Yeah, he did manage to survive. We got EXP 940, Sacred Text of Martial Arts, Book for Grown-Ups, Bronze Compass, Power 14. Alright. Armed with knowledge that a pair of powerful Saiyans will arrive on Earth in 1 year's time, the warriors began to prepare for the tough fight ahead. Oh, that's King Kai. He made it to King Kai's planet after Planet Snake. After Snake Way. Oh, King Kai is voiced by Sean Schemmel as well. Let's see. A cow with no legs. It's called a ground beef. Now that's the one he already told. Try again. Let's see. Have a nice trip. See you next fall. Yep. That's the right choice. He starts laughing. King Kai is the prince of puns. If you tell King Kai a joke, he will train you. Yeah, he sure likes jokes and puns and stuff. You got training community leader King Kai and unlocked a new community board. In this community, you can activate community skills that boost EXP and defense along other effects. Focus on this community if you want to handle battles more strategically. Alright, let's see here. Okay, never mind it. skip that. Oh, this is gonna be. It was really funny how Goku captures Bubbles and hits Gregor in the head with a mallet. Goku finally arrives at King Kai's plan and begins his training. Meanwhile, Gohan has grown stronger thanks to this cruel demands placed on him in the wilderness. And why does this character not have his armor on? Just took it off or something? Is that a silhouette of the Saiyans? And Goku? And a big ape? Over there? Oh, look at Gohan munching on apples. Mean green teaching machine. Well, hold up. Defeat the wandering dinosaur and get its meat. Can knock out dinosaurs roaming around the field by hitting them with ki blasts, causing them to drop food and materials. Once hit, the dinosaur will charge towards you, and if they hit you, you'll be knocked back, but they won't deal any damage. Keep your distance and stay calm as you try to take them down. I'm gonna take down that annoying dinosaur over there, like this. Then he gets really angry. It roars at you. Come on. No, you can't fly right now, so just knock him out. Yeah, that's right. What do we get? Lean dynamite. Perfect. Piccolo came. Gohan had finally begun his training with Piccolo. In order to learn how to fly, he first had to master how to use his ki. Under the harsh tutelage of Piccolo, Gohan gradually learned to control his ki. Alright, you can now fly while playing as Gohan. I think I'm getting the hang of this flying thing. Prepare yourself for battle and challenge Piccolo. Oh, this is before the Saiyans have arrived, that is. What are we gonna do? Let's talk to Fortune Teller Baba. You remember Linda Young did the voice of Fortune Teller Baba? She also did the voice of Frieza in the original Dragon Ball Z. Linda Young also did the voice of Genkai from Yu Yu Hakusho. Let's talk to him. Talk to her. Okay, you okay, ma'am? Boop, boop. The old woman's being attacked by a rogue robot. Go to her aid and beat that bucket of bolts. Get 141 experience, one D medal, awesome book for grown-ups, only one, and one fancy urn. Here we go. Foggy Future. I'm a little scared, but I have to help that woman. Alright, time to go. Mine. Oh, cool. You can send opponents on the wall. Boom. In your faces. Phew. Can't believe I was able to take it out. Well done, boy. You saved me. It's not safe for you to be here, ma'am. There are all sorts of dangerous things out here. I'm well aware of that. But there is something here I absolutely must have. I was actually hoping to send my assistants in my place. But of course, they're complaining of stomach aches and headaches. I don't know why I keep them around. So that's why I come here alone. What is it you came here to find? Oh, my, you're a curious one. This is what I'm after. Fortune Teller Baba showed Gohan a beautiful stone. It's a stone. This
is no ordinary stone. It possesses the power I need to strengthen the crystal ball I use for readings. Oh, so you're a fortune teller? Oh, ho, ho, indeed. I'm fortune teller Baba. Your father and I will actually go way back. What? My dad? You know my dad? Yes, I know him since he was a child. Wow. I won't say any more of your relationships. If you want to know about it, you should ask your father when he comes back. Now then, back to my crystal ball. I intend to use the stone's power to help see me into Earth's future. Recently, I haven't been able to see much whenever I try to look into a planet's future. I fear I may fail to learn of an impending tragedy, so I was hoping to use the stone to increase my crystal ball's power. Oh, I know. I can test my ball's new power by seeing your future. I do owe you for saving me. Thank you, but I'm actually kind of in a hurry. Oh, I would take no time at all. And I would take this free reading if I were you. My readings normally cost a fortune. We're talking 10 million zenny per reading. I'm willing to waive that fee just this once. Wow, you weren't kidding. That is a fortune. Okay, I'll take the reading. That's a good boy. Let's get started. Oh, hoy, 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 poi, and ha! Oh my, oh my, oh my. Well now, what do you see? You're kind of scaring me. Please say something. You're stressing me out. Your future will no doubt be filled with hardship after hardship. Hardships? Your life will be an uphill battle. I'll be honest, I've never seen a life this punishing before. Oh no. I do see a very faint but strong light at the end of the tunnel, so it's not all doom and gloom. Well, thank you, ma'am, for the reading. I better get going. My readings are 100% accurate, so when I say there's light, there's light. Now, on to Earth's future. Oh, hoy, 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 boy, and ha. It seems two orbs of some kind will land here. I'm getting only darkness after that. What's wrong with this thing? It just increases its power. I suppose this means something unbelievable is going to happen. Darkness. That young boy's future was filled with darkness as well, but there was a visible light. Perhaps that boy's future and the planets are connected on some deep level. Well, they are certainly not connected. That boy is Goku's son, after all. Whatever tragedy may befall this planet, I'm sure we'll be in safe hands. I expect great things from you, Gohan. Yay. So I'm guaranteed to face extreme hardships, huh? Alright. Now we've just rescued Fortune Teller Baba. That's good. I'm gonna start beating up some robots. Oh yeah, Gregory was voiced by John Bergemeyer too. Who else did John Bergemeyer voice? Let's see here. Come on, think. He also did. Let's see. I know. Dulcete from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. He's one of Greed's henchmen. Yep. I remember.
I'm gonna go to characters. See if I can upgrade my Mustenko, Body Impact. But Bone Shattering Melee Strike leaves enemies vulnerable if it connects. Both high stun damage sends enemies hurling into the ground. High guard breaks damage. Yep. Mustenko unleashes charge key as a devastating beam. High consumption for high damage. Yep. Okay. You gotta use the battle for Earth against the Saiyan invasion. That's for sure. Let's see here. Spring power. Yep. Okay. Super attack ballet. Nope. Let's see here. Items. Let's see here. Materials, gifts, vent. Mega Mass. Protein drink. Alright. Take this one. Alright. Here we go. He sounds like Luffy when he talks. That's not enough experience points, is there? Break something over there. Oh, we're gonna go to Piccolo and battle him. As you know, he's at a level 6. Meteor Sledge. No. Come on, use your Mustenko Blast. What? Ow! That is really harsh. Come on. No. Stop that. Yes. It's not over yet, dude. Still gotta train harder to become stronger so you can beat the Saiyans. Oh, nighttime again. I remember Piccolo had to destroy the moon after cutting Gohan's tail off. Some time passed, and Gohan's intense training with Piccolo on Earth continued. Now Gohan flies away. Lag. Head towards Goku's house on the world map. Gohan's going AWOL. What does AWOL mean?
Ladies and gentlemen, let the 24th World Tournament begin! You caught me by surprise there. I was about to get ready for the next World Tournament, but I'm thinking about changing things up a bit. But if you know, my intro's broken, I probably shouldn't try to fix it, huh?
Yeah, you already said that last time, but let's check our map. Go to the world map. Southeast Mountain area has been unlocked. Central Plains area has now been unlocked. I'm going to Goku's house right now. Having grown tired of the strict training regimen, Piccolo has him following Gohan, attempts to sneak home to catch his breath. On his way, he encounters a certain someone. What is a certain someone, exactly? Freedom, time for a breather, end your training session early and sneak home. When Yamcha's hideout. That was from the old Dragon Ball. Hey look, Nam's there. I felt woefully unprepared recently, so I'm traveling around hoping to increase my strength. I heard a fighter named Yamcha who once participated in the World Tournament lived around here. If I can find him, I would very much like to spar with him. Yeah, I know, Nam. But I would wear my shoes if I were you. Come on. Okay. You can also sense your key too. Okay. Is there a training spot there? There it is. Nope. Let's go to that city over there. But first, let's go deal with some robots. Level up. Awesome. Totally awesome. Oh, look. Orange City. Come on. Track field. Look, Dr. Briefs. And Dr. Briefs is voiced by Mark Stoddard, who also does the doctor from My Hero Academia. Evil character. Oh, sorry, I don't like loud, busy places. Not that I like the country better, but the bugs really freak me out.
the wrong button. Like a dish. You still need more peaches. Well, they also got mango there. Come on. Get some more. Juicy steamed bun. A meaty, juicy bun. It's piping hot and extra savory. If there's anything you want me to make, just let me know. Why are there beastmen there? Cool. Alright. Now can I get out of there, please? Thank you. Still gotta get some more items so I can level up. More peaches. Come on, get some more peaches. Yes. Oh, there's that annoying pig over there in Oolong. He's also a pervert too. Now, Oolong is voiced by Brian Massey in this game, who does the voice of Red Riot from My Hero Academia and Rady Spirito from Black Clover, the anime. I was trying to head to the village up ahead, but I got blown away by some crazy strong wind, and when I came to, I found myself there. What in the world's going on? What an annoying pig. I can't stand him anymore. Oh, look. We're heading to Goku's house. All right. Die. Okay, come on. More apples. This poor. Oh, Poir is also voiced by Brandon Palencia. Yep. Oh, what do we got there? Those red aura enemies are called villainous enemies. Evil foes known as villainous enemies have sinister crimson auras and are much more powerful than normal enemies. Take them out on your own risk. Wow, it's really going to be a big friggin' pain. Come on. Charge up your... Get away from me. Charge up your key. Watch out for the missiles. You're on a low level against these annoying enemies like that. Oh, they take no damage. Come on. One last hit. Boom. Oh, look. We got some special items from being villainous enemies. We got Soul Emblem for Poir. More experience points. Powerful foes known as villainous enemies can now be encountered in all around the world. Defeating them will net you rare Z orbs and rare special items. Continue to defeat villainous enemies, even more powerful ones will appear. Stronger the enemy, the greater the rewards. So take them on if you dare. Head to the Blake Bog on the world map. Okay. But first of all, I gotta finish. Right now, I gotta take down these annoying Skull Robo types. Die. Oh man, stop hitting me like that. Okay, let's just check our character. Okay, once I head to the Blake Bog, let's see here. Nope. We got some villainous enemy appeared. Filled with a new scene of resolve, Gohan makes his way back to Piccolo to continue his training. Well, the battle with the Saiyans go will hinge on how much Gohan's able to improve. Goodness. This Muscle Tower, the Red Ribbon Army Tower. Bases will now appear on the field. Bases can be destroyed with key blasts and will leave behind items once destroyed. Naturally, the bases will harm them. Don't be bases. Get to the training grounds and show Piccolo you're tough enough. For the base, you get special items. They're all level 2 and there are 3 of these.
stuck there. Yeah, I remember the Red Ribbon Army, the criminal organization. They're a bunch of terrorists. And Goku has defeated the Red Ribbon Army. I remember Mercenary Tao killed Upa's father, Bora. That's just plain messed up. Mega Mass. Yeah, you said that already. Come on, let's move on. There we go. Knock that dinosaur out. Oh, great. That's two robots. They keep distracting me. Yes, there we go. We didn't get dino meat? You serious, man? First of all, I'm going to use my items like this. Oh no. No fish. No defense. Alright, tofu. There we go. Sweet. Thank you. Start by kicking the crap out of these skull robo types. Then we can go see Piccolo for now.
Now we're gonna fight Piccolo for the second time. Well, he's at a level 8 for sure. And he's a lot stronger than you. Come on. Come on, get away from me. Don't hit me in the face, Piccolo. Come on, charge up your key, bro. Please do it. Stop doing that. Okay. Oh, wow. Why does he keep dodging? Get away from me. Don't. Come on. Ow. Gotta make sure I keep my distance. Wow, I'm leveled up. Hurrah. Now we're in a different outfit. With a headband. Gohan now has long hair. Oh, Lord. More time passed. And the day the Saiyans would have arrived drew even closer. Skip that. Whoa. Goku got a lot of experience. And he learns the Spirit Bomb. Get that. Oh, there's Nappa and Vegeta. Battle with a dangerous duo. It appeared in Dragon Ball Z episode 22 where Nappa used that volcanic blast to destroy the city. Oh wow. Whoa. Deathmatch approaching. Hurry up to Piccolo and tell him about the huge key you sensed. Yep, the Saiyans have finally arrived. So then, let's go talk to Piccolo. Okay, come on. Over there. First, let's go deal with some of these annoying robots. Alright, why is Piccolo... Why did he take off the weighted clothes? Like the cape and the turban. And now the Saiyans have arrived. And we're gonna go battle the Cybermen. Three Cybermen. And Yamcha will help with your support. These Cybermen are very annoying. I remember Chaozu, Tien, Krillin, Piccolo, and Gohan fight the six Cybermen. Tien and Chaozu arrived. Yeah. Why did the Saiyans arrive in the first place? Yeah, the Cybermen are also voiced by John Bergmeier, too. Stay out of my way. Please don't kick my butt, you stupid Cybermen. Fine. Come on. Stop hitting me. What are you doing? Stop it. Oh. Come on. Down already, you. Oh man, he's got a salt claw. Die. Oh man, no, I don't get an S rank. Yes, I did. Oh, wow. This is where the Cyberman blew himself up by killing Yamcha. Well, now Nappa goes up in a battle and he's on a level 11, which is going to be a real pain. And Solar Flare will be able to blind your enemies. Come on, charge up your key, man. Oh man, Nappa's a strong Saiyan. In other words, oh, he's got a giant storm attack. He's gonna be annoying. Watch out for it. I mean, come on, Nappa. You big brute. Oh, wow. Use Solar Flare on Nappa. He's got a lot of health. For a Saiyan that big, he's got a lot of health. And he dodged it? Unfreaking believable, man. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, use Solar Flare. Yeah, now use Solar Flare to blind this dude. Come on, watch out for the move arm break. Giant storm. Take that. Oh, take that, Nappa. Super attack tree has been unlocked. Alright. Oh, wow. I remember that. Chiaotzu, talk to everyone about, to find out what the Sinister Saiyans. 3 hours. This is horrible. Chiaotzu blew himself up. He sacrificed himself for nothing. He blew up on Nappa, but it didn't affect him. That was after Nappa chopped off Tien's arm. It's freaking messed up. Then after Chiaotzu's death, Tien used a very powerful tri-beam by consuming all of his energy, and then he dies. And Vegeta tells Nappa, this Goku you mentioned was referring to is Kakarot. That's right. And they're going to have to do 3 hours. If Goku decides not to show up, then they're gonna attack him. Alright. Alright then, let's go talk to Nappa first. Better talk to everyone to find out what to do about the Sinister Saiyans. Stay out of my way, you stupid Cybermen. Yeah, the Cybermen are one of the henchmen of the Saiyans. Oh, Krillin blew up Cybermen, and also Piccolo did a powerful breath attack on the Cybermen. Well, let's talk to Vegeta. What's wrong? You tired of waiting for Kakarot? Well, why is some of his armor parts broken? Nappa's armor parts broken. It's because Tien used Tri-Beam on him, but it didn't damage him. What do you want, kid? You itching to get your head beaten already? Yeah, he is a sadistic Saiyan. But first of all, I'm gonna start beating up those annoying robots. Stop hitting me. I think we're gonna have to call it quits for now. Okay, let's call it quits this time. Yep, come on, get up there, go on. There we go. Okay, that's it for this Let's Play of Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and I, GableGaming5000K, will sign off. And I'll see you next time, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, everyone.